It must be recognized that man, in his limited and relative, it must be recognized that man in his limited and relative earthly life is capable of bringing about the beautiful and the valuable only when he believes in another life, unlimited, absolute, and eternal. This is a law of his being, and it's the quote from The End of Our Life, End of Our Time, 1919, by Nikolai Alexandrovich Berdyaev, and today's episode is dedicated to him. So, hello and welcome to my philosophical and musical channel. And Nikolai Alexandrovich Berdyaev and his autobiography, Self-Knowledge, so-called Self-Knowledge. The experience of philosophical autobiography has existed in history as a special genre for a long time. It's not something new. Here we can give an example such as Confession of Saint Augustine or Augustinus Aurelius, the book of Jean-Jacques Rousseau with the same title, and of course The Truth and the Poetry and Truth by Goethe. And it should be noted that Berdyaev already in the very title noticed and he emphasizes his own approach to creating such a biography, such philosophical biography. This is not just a diary, which the author has never kept and notifies the reader about it almost immediately, just in preface. This is an attempt to attempt at self-reflection, self-reflection which requires spiritual effort and rather great effort. Berdyaev notes a penchant for existential philosophizing and cognition of oneself and others through oneself is just a way to recognize all over the world and all this world and human being. The book was created in the late period of time, 8 years before the author's death, and her draft was called Philosophical Autobiography and was created in 1939-1940. The published book appeared already in 1948 after the death of Nikolai Berdyaev. In my opinion, it not only sums up, but also deepens the views of the author. The passionate tone of the presentation sharpens the controversy with some philosophical systems. And this video, by the way, is dedicated to philosophical views more than just autobiography, because otherwise it would be too extended and large. So, personality and the world, and these two concepts very significant for philosophy and for Berdyaev, of course, too. And Aristotle in his Ethic of Nicomach reveals the motives of human behavior, which are based on choosing the beautiful, useful and pleasant, and avoiding the ugly, harmful and unpleasant. Pleasure and suffering govern all our actions, some more, other less, and so on and so forth. And, however, Berdyaev builds a completely different model of understanding of human being, human personality. The origins of man can only partially be understood and rationalized. The mystery of the personality, its uniqueness, is not fully understood by anyone. It's just impossible to understand it completely. The human personality is more mysterious than the world, and is the words from the Self-Knowledge. A person cannot be defined as a political animal, zoon politikon, as you know, a part of society and a part of state, and so on and so forth. That is the ancient paradigm. Is overcome by the Christian worldview and attitude to the individual. Moreover, Berdyaev emphasizes that the characteristic feature of Russian people is their rejection of the balanced world order that is characteristic of the thinking of people of Western civilization. We are anarchistic and nihilistic people, to tell the truth. Any state institution evoked associations with the Inquisition and the suppression of personality for Berdyaev. Moreover, the author's polemical tone and sense of contradiction arise not only when confronted with human society as a society. A characteristic feature of Berdyaev is the sharpening of his own thoughts through reading. It's a very important concept for philosopher, to tell the truth. He notes that he could never passively memorize or just cram something, anything. His ability were most actively manifested in the development of his own thoughts, his own views. Here we can recall Martin Heidegger, of course, and his work What Does It Mean to Think? And he emphasizes that the interest shown in philosophy is an indicator, and it indicates a willingness to think, and the fact that we have been persistently studying the writings of great thinkers for years doesn't guarantee that we are thinking or at least ready to learn to think. Practicing philosophy can even create for us a persistent illusion that we are thinking, since we are philosophizing. We are just quoting something, somebody. But the process of thinking implies the independent creation of the concept. Only in this case it's possible to get into thinking, to deepen into thinking. This means the rejection of the research scientific method, because according to Heidegger, science doesn't think. Science combines and accumulates the data. No more, no less. For Heidegger, it's so. Nihilistic negation and reevaluation of values fully correspond to the spirit of time and to the spirit of Berdyaev's worldview. He constantly emphasizes his anti-authoritarianism, auto-totalitarianism, and autonomy, the inability to adapt to the environment, to the society. At the same time, Berdyaev has a complicated attitude to Nietzsche and Nietzscheanism. He sees in the concept of this underhuman or overhuman, over anthropos, only an empty concept, which in its nihilistic mood is likened to a snake biting his own tail, its own tail. Zarathustra is the greatest human book without grace, says Berdyaev. And recognizing the greatness of Nietzsche, Berdyaev even looks with a certain contempt at Nietzscheanism as the concept, as something impotent, something empty. It's through Dostoevsky's anthropology that Berdyaev is overcoming the temptation of the superhuman man-god, and this is anti-Christianic tendency for Berdyaev. That is the absolute autonomy and alienation, abandonment, longing and loneliness that accompany Berdyaev throughout his life are overcome only eschatologically for him, in some kind of timeless renewal union with God. Moreover, such an opportunity is provided for a person in a creative free act, and creativity is a very important concept for Berdyaev, is a very important activity. So it's a free acceptance of the truth, but freedom is significant. It's a crucial point. Christianity for Berdyaev is a religion of freedom, of course. and a little bit about eras and split of personality. The attitude towards eras is, in fact, a continuation of the philosophy of freedom by Berdyaev and self-worth of the human personality, by the way. For Berdyaev, life is a continuation of an individual personal building and personal beginning. It's directed at a single, unique, irreplaceable person. Moreover, he distinguishes the life of sex as such, the life of a spontaneous and depersonalizing beginning from genuine erotic love as a unity and integrity. It's interesting that here, in my opinion, there is a direct polemic with Arthur Schopenhauer and his metaphysics of sexual life. You know, Schopenhauer interprets love precisely as the will to life, and therefore will to life embodied in the genus, in our genus. The individual arises as an idea in the genius of the genus, of human genus, and therefore has such an all-consuming power and an irresistible impact on our life. The inability to satisfy the longing for love results in the crying of the genus itself for his unborn individual. Berdyaev categorically, absolutely doesn't accept the generic and social aspect of love. Legal love is dead love for him. The socialization of love and marriage life is always repulsive as an institution based on hierarchy and not alien to slavery. Interest in Schopenhauer, however, was characteristic for Jan Berdyaev. Who expressed himself in dissatisfaction with the visible world. Subsequently, he moved away from Schopenhauer, of course, and he says about it, but something Schopenhauer remained in him, and Schopenhauer's voluntarism has always remained close to him. So, the task, the aim of philosophizing for Berdyaev is precisely to identify a certain primordial reality of the subject, of human being, of human existence. And free creativity is a tool for finding yourself and being true to yourself. So, thank you very much for your attention. I hope that this Russian excerpt from Russian culture is useful. Thank you for your attention. All good to you and bye.